Hello, welcome to Earth Engine Tutorial episode 43. In this video, I'm going to show you how to extract pixel values to point shapefile using Google's engine. Let's get started. So first of all, you need to download the Jupyter Notebook example that we're going to use for this tutorial. You can go to the gmap.org, and then from there you can click the GitHub icon and you will navigate to the GitHub website, and you can go to examples, notebooks, scroll down to see number 43, then click the raw button, right click save as. You can download this one to folder within your computer. I'm going to download to my downloads folder. If you see from here, already downloaded it to my computer. So after that, you can activate Jupyter Notebook to open the notebook example. So I'm going to first conda activate GE, and then just type Jupyter Notebook. Open Jupyter Notebook on browser, and all you need to do is just to click notebook. Okay, so I'm going to maximize the window. As you can see from here, this example is relatively simple and straightforward. So first of all, we're going to import the libraries, and keep that in mind, you need to update to the latest one. I haven't released the new package to Conda yet, so you probably need to install from GitHub. So I'm going to show you, for example, what kind of function I'm going to use. You can go to the gmap.org and you can type extract pixel values to points. So it will be this function. If you want to see the source code, you can scroll down. This is the function, and here are some of the parameters. If you want to see the source code behind, you can click the link in here to look at the source code. It's not very complicated. Essentially, we behind the scene, we use the image.sample regions to get the pixel values, and we can pass in a shapefile point type. You just need to have the Earth Engine image, and in output, you can save it as a CSV or a shapefile. Okay, let's go back to the notebook example. So first of all, we already execute. If you haven't installed the latest one, you can control slash to uncomment this line, and then hit control enter to execute this one. After that, we can create the interactive map. Okay, so this is the default, the gmap base map. And so next, let's add some data. So I'm going, in this example, I'm going to add a DM and also a lane set data. And you can customize how you want to visualize the data. Then add these two data layers. Execute. See, right, we have the DM, we have the lens set data. We have two data layers. We're going to use a shapefile to extract the pixel values. Next, let's go ahead to download some sample data. If you already have some shapefiles on your computer, you can use your own data set. All you need to do is just to change this one to the absolute path to your data. So you can, like, if you're using Windows, it can be C and then to the file path, or Mac or Linux, you just need to pass in the absolute path. So in this example, I'm going to download some sample data from the other GitHub repo. As you can see from here, the repo called data, and download the US cities shapefile. Execute. Might take a few seconds. So now the data is already downloaded to our computer, and you can see from here, this is the file that we downloaded, and it unzipped, contains some data sets, so a GeoJSON and also a shapefile. Next, what we need to do is to add the data to the map, but in order to add shapefile to the map, we need to convert it to Earth Engine object. So we are calling this function SSP to EE, and passing the data set that we get from here, okay? And then we can add the data to the map. This might take a couple seconds, depends on the file size of your data set. So as you can see from here, we have thousands of points for the US cities. Click and check. Okay. And so the next step is to extract the pixel values. As you can see here, we have two data layers. The first one is the DM, and the second one is the Landsat multispectral data. So we're going to do two examples. The first one, we're going to extract the DM and then save the data as a shred file. The next one, we're going to just extract the pixel values and then save it as a CSV. But you can also do a CSV or shred file. It's up to you. And so first, we need to define the output file path. Where do we want to save the file path? So we, because we already set the working directory as the downloads folder, and essentially this one is saying that we're going to create a variable, we're going to export the data, and then under the downloads folder, and it's named the DM shred file. Then we call this function extract pixel extract values to points, and you can pass in the parameters. So the input visual collection. So this is the this one, the shred file, then we convert it to a visual collection, and we pass in the image and also the output. So input, image, and then the output. If you want to see more information, you can shift tab on your keyboard to bring take a look at the help documentation. So you can actually pass in more parameters in here. We only use the first three. But if you have a shred file, you have a lot of attributes. You, if you only want to keep certain attributes or properties, you can pass in a list. If you don't pass anything by default, it's going to keep all the attribute information. You can also set a scale, depends on the image resolution. If you want a coarser resolution, you can set the scale and projection, and also the last one, geometry. So because we're passing image visual collection, a shred file, but when you export, if you don't want the geometry, you can set this one to false. But you can also just change this one to a CSV. If it's a CSV, then it's going to eliminate all the geometries. Okay, so let's look at the first one. Let's just execute the first one and see what happens. We open the downloads folder. So right now, we don't have the data set yet. It's going to extract the data set to download the shred file to your computer. So it might take a couple of seconds. Okay, it's done. So now we have this one, the DM shred file. And if you want to open, you can certainly open using QGIS or ArcGIS. So I'm going to open in QGIS. Let me take a look here. And let me add a base map. Base map. Then we can drag this one map. All we need to do is just right click, open attribute table. And so you can see here, this is the elevation that we extracted. Okay. We can also add the original data set to see what's in there. For the US cities, again, we add this one to here. Open, right click, attribute table. All right, so now you can see this one does not have the elevation column. So the other one here we just extracted. Now this one has the elevation. You see here for all the points, more than 3,000. Okay. So this is the first example that you can you for the image. You can also do it for Landsat data or any other image. If you want, you can also pass in image collection, but you need to convert the image collection to image. Then you just call collection to dot to bands, and then you will be able to convert that one to an image, and it can be a time series of images. In this way, you can extract the time series for all the pixels of your points. So last one, we're going to extract the pixel value from the Landsat data using the same cities shred file. So all we need to do is just hit one. Let's take a look. So this one is going to, because the DM only has one specs, one image band, but for the Landsat data we have more than one. So take a look at this one here, download it, click okay. And so you will see here B3, B2, 6, 4, 5, 7, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. So 6 spectral bands. As you can see here, the spectral bands, the column might not be ordered alphabetically, because when OSNG exporting the data, sometimes it depends on which column is retrieved first, so it might not be organized in a way that you want, but you can certainly move those columns, resize, reorder the columns, and these are all the pixel values being extracted. So this can be particularly helpful if you want to, for example, do some lane use lane cover classification. You already have the lane cover typed for your training data, but you want to extract pixel values from different images, then you can use this way. So basically you have the swap file with the lane cover type, and then use the swap file to convert to any object. Then you can use the extract values to points to extract all the pixel values. And then once you have the file, you can use that one to do supervised or unsupervised classification, and also do accuracy assessment. You can also extract time series, like I mentioned earlier. If you have an image collection of, let's say, NDVI, a vegetation index, if you want to extract all the pixel values, no matter how many years you have or how many months, you just need to have the image, and then you pass in the swap file you have, and then you will be able to extract all the time series vegetation indices. You turn this one on and off. You can also add the data back to the map if you want after you do the extraction. Okay, so that's pretty much for this tutorial. If you enjoyed this video, please consider hitting the like button and subscribe to my channel. Hope to see you in my next video. Take care. Bye bye.